Hey, it's Thomas here, and today we're gonna be checking out Ceche's whale canister filter. And yes, I just said canister filter. I can feel the glare from the roofing community coming right through the camera, but hear me out because I really think they were wrongfully shunned. Now, for those who skipped freshwater and went directly to saltwater, you're probably not very familiar with the canister filter, so before we do anything else, let's fix that. The canister filter is a closed container to hold a variety of filter media, most often all three stages, including mechanical, chemical, and biological media, with a motor built into the lid and a pair of hoses to take water from and return water to the aquarium. It's basically a media reactor that has a motor built into it rather than needing to use an external pump, and they've been favored heavily in the freshwater world because they take up less space on the rim of the tank, allowing you to get the tank closer to the wall. They generally hold more media and they run much quieter, often silent, compared to hang-on power filters. And while they are hugely popular on the freshwater side of things, they don't get nearly as much love on the saltwater side, which I personally think is a dang shame since they definitely have a place in reefing. Heck, I had a skimmerless 20-gallon SPS dominated reef that ran on a canister filter and it did very well, but I'll explain how I pulled that off in just a little bit. Where I think the majority of reefers are gonna find benefit in a canister filter like this one is going to be with things like periodic water polishing, whether it's mechanical or chemical filtration, things like adding extra filtration to an all-in-one system that's already jam-packed in that rear chamber, there's no more space for anything else, or even adding filtration to a quarantine system that will allow you to have an external inline heater or UV sterilizer without having to add more pumps or taking up space in the tank. If those sound like scenarios that you've been trying to find a solution for, Ceche's whale canister filters are a really great option. They're built tough by a company known for having a fantastic warranty and customer service to match. They are user-friendly with features that make maintenance simple and easy, like large media baskets, a removable valve block, simple priming, a strainer with a built-in check valve, and serviceable intake and output assemblies. They come ready to go with media, tubing, and everything you'll need to get them set up. Plus, they look pretty dang slick with that glossy piano black finish. In the box, you'll find the canister filter with the media baskets and the media inside of it, the soft and rigid tubing, the installation sets and parts that include the intake assembly, the output assembly, a 90-degree elbow, a water deflector, an intake strainer, 4 hose clamps, 4 suction cups, 4 rubber feet for the canister body, and 3 media basket handles, as well as the instructions and a quality control card. The whale canisters come in 4 different sizes, including the 120, 200, 350, and 500, rated for aquariums between 10 and 90 gallons when being used as the primary filter. They push 140, 190, 330, and 390 gallons per hour respectively, and have 1.5 liters, 2.2 liters, 5.2 liters, and 7 liters of media capacity. They also come ready to go right out of the box with media, including 10 PPI and 20 PPI foam pads, as well as pore ceramic biomedia. The media is preloaded into the square media baskets inside of the canister, but make sure you remove the biomedia from the plastic package before running the filter. The square media baskets also make swapping and cleaning the media a whole lot easier, and their shape makes using cut to fit or off-brand media really, really easy for those who prefer to buy those types of media in bulk. These canisters have a lot more going for them as well. Not only are they super quiet when they're running and look really sleek with that glossy piano black finish, but they are also very user-friendly. The intake assembly has a plunger rod and check valve for easy priming. The output assembly has a valve for flow control. The output is multi-directional, so you can send the flow wherever you need it to go in the tank. The valve block has a single-stage quick-release lever that both closes off the tubes and releases them from the canister in one motion. It also has a pair of rotating barbs to make placement of the canister easier, regardless of where you want the tubes to go. The locking clips that hold the lid onto the body are two-stage and have a very nice, firm click to them. The tubing is gray to prevent any kind of algae growth, and it has thick walls so they don't easily kink. Ceche also includes very simple but effective hose clamps and easy grab handles for the media baskets. Long story short, Ceche did what they do best. And just like with all of their aquarium pumps, they made this canister filter, you know, super user friendly, easy to work with, and built to last. Doing maintenance on this filter is also really simple. Unplug it from the wall, pop off the valve block and take it to a sink or tub, undo the clips, pop off the lid, and you have access to those media baskets for a media swap. For a more thorough cleaning of the motor housing, you can access the impeller by flipping over the lid of the canister and giving the impeller cover a twist following the direction of the arrow to unlock it. Then you can pop it right off and pull the impeller out for a quick scrub. Also, both the intake and output assemblies come apart to make cleaning them easier, which is great. Like I mentioned earlier, I actually used a canister filter very similar to this one as the primary filter on an SPS-dominated reef tank, which I'm sure some of you are saying is probably a bad idea, but I'm gonna go ahead and argue that one. Basically, if you're gonna use a canister filter, there's a couple of things you have to consider and do for it to work properly. Number one, you'll notice canister filters have a lower flow rating, and to get around that, you're gonna end up using a canister filter that is rated for a tank much larger than the one you're putting it on. And the reason that it's so low is because they're tailoring the flow to the contact time of the biomedia, but our reef tanks want a little bit more flow. So you go with a larger canister filter on a smaller reef tank, no big deal. There's one more thing you really have to do as well, and that is to take all of the fine mechanical media, whether it's fine foam pads or polishing pads or filter batting or anything like that, and pitch it aside. Because if you use it in the canister, it's gonna bog up very quickly and you'll be going in and doing maintenance on it weekly or bi-weekly, which we don't want to do. If you just use a coarse foam pad on the bottom, which is where the water is going to enter through first, and fill the rest of the trays with biomedia, you'll get all of the biological support that you need from the canister filter and only have to do monthly maintenance, which is a lot better than doing weekly or bi-weekly, which is also why I generally won't use any sort of chemical media if I'm running a canister filter as the primary filter. You always have the option if you need it, but if you want to stick to that monthly maintenance, which you definitely want to do if you're using one of these, just leave it out. And then you're good to go. Now, for the rest of you reefers out there that are going to use a canister filter for things like periodic maintenance, such as bi-weekly or monthly water polishing, the following setup I find works really well for me. Starting with the very bottom basket in the canister going up, I like to use 10 PPI foam pads, then 20 PPI foam pads, then a fine filter pad like felt, floss, or batting, and then top that off with a high quality bag of carbon. Then you can let it run for the entire day or even overnight, but usually not longer than 48 hours, and you'll pull out all of those tiny bits of dust and specks floating around in the water while also removing yellowing pigments from the water for a crystal clear tank, which is a great thing to do right before you have like a dinner party or family coming over so that the tank looks immaculate and you can show it off. If CJ's whale canister filters match your reefing mantra, you can go ahead and pick one up for yourself, whether it's for some periodic maintenance or maybe setting up a nano tank, by clicking right here.